2.5 years ago, scientists used the most complicated machine ever to solve one of the greatest puzzles to vex the human race. And then they went, yeah, but what if we kicked it up a notch? Greetings, Atom Smashers. Julian here for DNews. The Large Hadron Collider made headlines years ago when it confirmed the existence of the Higgs boson. This was huge news in the world of particle physics because the discovery solved a few quarks. As we understand it, there are subatomic particles that carry the fundamental forces, except gravity, as far as we know, called bosons. In order for the math to work, these bosons should be massless, and yet we actually observed some of them and found that certain kinds of bosons did indeed have mass. To solve the problem, it was proposed by Peter Higgs and other researchers in the 60s that a field existed everywhere all the time, and moving through this field gave bosons and other particles their mass. The math predicted that if the field was excited by high-energy collisions, you could jiggle the field in just the right way to briefly spring another particle together, and that particle is what we call the Higgs boson. But scientists weren't content to just dust their hands off on their lab coats and call it a day. No, no, no. They decided to build a 27-kilometer underground loop of supercooled magnets and tubes and cameras 5 stories high so they could take pictures of protons smashing together at nearly the speed of light, and they did it with no guarantee the Higgs boson could be found or even existed. And you thought asking out your crush was risky. But when they first flipped the switch in 2008, there was a problem. One measly connecting wire in the over 10,000 used for the superconducting magnets failed and damaged the LHC. When it was brought back online, it could only run at half its intended power. Then they found the Higgs boson anyway. This machine answered one of the greatest questions ever asked with one hand tied behind its back. But there's more work to do. You see, the math doesn't predict an exact value for the Higgs, and if the Higgs boson has certain masses, it implies vastly different things. One possible mass equation suggests the Higgs has is 115 giga electron volts over the speed of light squared, which supports the idea of supersymmetry, or more particles to add to the standard model that we haven't found yet. But the Higgs could also have a mass of around 140 GeV, and that suggests a favorite theory of sci-fi, the multiverse. A mass that high could lend credibility to the idea that there are many universes with Higgs bosons of different masses, and ours just happens to be a universe that has a Higgs field just right to keep everything stable. So, what is the actual mass of the Higgs boson? About 125 GeV over c squared. So, supersymmetry or multiverse? Both? We have no idea. That's why in March the LHC is coming back. It's here to kick butt and chew bubble gum, and it's all out of bubble gum. It's going to be twice as powerful with tougher wiring, it'll have better cooling to keep its superconducting magnets at 1.9 degrees above absolute zero, and it's had its cameras upgraded for more precise measurement. And when it spools up, no one knows what we'll find. Supersymmetric particles, candidates for dark matter, nothing at all? We're just gonna have to wait and see. If bosons and fermions and quarks is all just a bunch of gibberish to you, we have a video on what all those mean. Check it out. There are gauge bosons which carry force. Gluons carry the strong force, Z and W bosons carry the weak force, and our old friend the photon carries the electromagnetic force. Then there's the Higgs boson, which comes into existence when the Higgs field is excited. It proves that the Higgs field exists, and the Higgs field explains away some problems of the standard model. Or if you're on your mobile, there's a link in the description below. So, what do you think the LHC will find? Do not say it'll make a black hole. That is not how that works. Well, let us know in the comments, and I'll see you next time on DNews. Oh great, now everyone's going to say black holes.